Yeah, once we get the connection pass, there it is. It's just that I'm sliding right out. Obviously, at this point, he wants to stay balled up, and now I don't have anything to get in here. I'm going to keep him smashing into him here. He's got the frame to beat me. But when I take his leg down and I smash down here, and I walk around, even if he's on his side, breaking and pushing me, I can win this time here, and I'm able to switch in and go through. I have gravity on my side. Plus, I have, like, and a lot of times, too, it's like, at this point, my guys are defending it here. It's not a game of miles, it's a game of inches, and I don't have to rush. Right? My body is blocking that here. What I want to avoid is him making this connection right here. This is a great conditional connection, that elbow knee. It's very difficult for me just to settle into a pin position. Alright? So, nice thing is about this position is like, yeah, this is like, we just went over it super basic here, but by the end of the month, we're going to be kind of progressing it into other variations of getting into this. And like, that's actually one of the best ways right there, like past spider guard. When guys are looking for spider guard, is to hit this old school Toriano pass. Like I used to do a lot of, like, there's variations of this. Like there's active passing, if that guy sits up into us, the whole series that we can go off of this. Alright? But again, this starts to set us up really good for our side control. Right, so I'm in here, I'm getting in a side control position, and I'm getting my underhook, and I'm going from there. So, we're going to work a lot on, like I said, cross side arm bars and cross side attacks here. So, in general here, what we're working to do is we're going to be working to get this arm isolated and over to here. Alright? Obviously from here, it's difficult to do. There's a lot of different ways that I can go about this. But one way, I need to work on it and start to look for that Americana and start to create that art obstacle. And now I'm going to back. Alright. But for the sake of today, guys, we're just going to be starting in this type of position right here. Alright, so God is what I'm looking for. What I'm going to work here, guys, is like, if I'm looking for the armbar here, if Jeff right now raises both of his hands up to the sky here, right, he's got equidistance here, right? So he's got equal exposure on the arm, and 9 times out of 10, he's flat like this, I'm probably going to make you just one to try to attack. If I'm looking to attack this far side here, I want to get Jeff on his side. Look at, yep, see how that starts to expose that arm and elongates the arm and gives me a better structure to look to attack. So I'm in here, guys, and in this control, what I'm going to do is I release my grip, this hand coming up to the tricep. As I bring that tricep up, I'm bringing my elbow into his rib. Right? I'm the ribs in the sternum here. I'm pulling his head up, and a lot of times I will push his head down. If I need to, I can push my, I can also plant that behind the head if I want to as well. But like at this point, once I get it up here, like the point of my elbow is just kind of sitting in his rib cage. Alright? I'm looking to get this on the tricep here. I'm pinching a little bit with my head. And I'm looking to elongate this out. So if I pull this in here, so like people have been struggling a little bit, they've been down here with this. It's like one of those times where like, and this is why I like to push down the head. It's still difficult for him to move. He doesn't have good posture, but now I can go a little bit higher up. See, like, once I go higher up, that starts to lock up the elbow here, and it starts to isolate the shoulder. Alright? So from this position, guys, the basic step over arm bar here, my hand, like, my leg gets close to the head, is going to take a big step around. I'm looking to step all the way to the back of the shoulder. Right here, step up. Alright? And now I rotate, like, spin it around this arm. Here, my shin comes along his rib cage here, and I want the top of my foot against his back. My other leg's kind of coming in here tight, and I'm going to grab, like, hold the pant legs and pull back. All right. A lot of times in this position, guys, if I'm wearing the gi, I'll grab hold of my own towel. Alright? Grab hold of the wrist slide. Alright? So from here, obviously, for my finish here, I'm moving this into my body. My hips raise up. Alright?
I'm in my side control position here. I scoop back. I swing the head. My head up high. And it's like the two hard parts that people are struggling with is like they come up here with this, they kind of work their way all the way around. I'm stepping all the way through. Boom, here. My hips are up here high, and I rotate through and around. Right? Get in here hugging, and I fall back.
What's that? So again, like a good rule of thumb on our bars, so you know that it's tight. If I fall back and Jeff's back moves that mat slightly, I know I got that arm tight. Like, not that I can't finish in my head, that doesn't happen, but like now that's where we're like, I'm trying to get Jeff to kind of move here. If I can hit that initial, like, that means that like his only option to try to avoid getting submitted right off the bat right then and there is to try to like pull one of those muscles there.
Kind of have two variations of this. One, I'm still in the same position that we just worked here. But now, instead of trying to come over the head, or if this guy is like blocking my hip here, what do? I bring this knee up, and I'm going to pivot around the opposite way. And slide in. Down here, boom, here. Bring the knee up. Slide it over, I'm almost coming into like an S-bow. Secure. Guys, I'm gonna train out, like, look, I'm here, like, and I'm in this position, which he generally feels pretty safe on. I can now still come through here and kick that over as well. Right, so notice, like, a lot of times here, like, I'm still falling towards the legs. Because the other thing, too, is like, what helps tighten this up, guys, is like I pull to my hip. That helps avoid this, right? Which is like the killer of that arm bar from like this position here. You get in this point. Now I'm trying to like try to strengthen it through and you lose the position. Whereas like if I sit in here and pop into that hip, you can't lock those hands up.
Yeah.
Like by that point, it's done. Alright? So again, kind of two variations of this. Here, boom, our pummel that we've just been working here. He blocks him here, boom, slide into the S mount. Come back in through. If he goes this other grip here, boom, and I'm in this position here. I still can bury this, and it almost becomes like an arm drag as I come through, and I'm here, boom, dragging it over.